I'm going to go ahead and put this compost bin together. So it's going to be two bins. It's going to be 70 inches wide. So two bins are going to be 35 inches wide. And we have a middle. This is the back of it. It's going to have a middle support. So this is all recycled. I don't know what that is, but those posts there are heavy as heck. They're farm boards. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and cut these boards 70 inches wide, all those back boards 70 inches, and then there's our side boards. I'm not sure how the smallest board, I think it's probably 30, 31, so it's not going to be that deep. I'm not trying to make a huge compost bin. We got the 8 big compost bins at the litter shed. So this is just for kitchen scraps and garden scraps. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that cut, get it nailed together, and I'll show you what it looks like. The last one's not pressure treated, so I'm gonna stain it anyway, but I'm just gonna put it on top since the soil probably won't get that high anyway. I'm going to make them about 2 inches apart. I'm going to use this board here as a spacer. I think 2 inches will give it the distance that it needs. I think that's two. Let's check. That's 2.5. That's 2.5 inches. You know, I don't think I want to go quite 2.5. That's a heck of a gap. I think I only want to go 2. Let's see. That board's 1.5 that way. Let me find something that's 2 inches. Let me find something that's close to 2 inches. Level on the side to make sure this side board is level. And it's not. It's just slightly off, but that's fine. We're going to go ahead and shoot this. Board, first board in. And then we're going to go over here and line up this side. Shoot this board in. Let's see. It's got a slight bend in it. It's not off by much. That's the second one, so that's how it's going to go all the way up. It's pretty much even. I put the level on here. And the rung, it's hard to tell with that, but they're pretty much, they're within the bubble, so within the margins. I think it'll be pretty good. It's not going to be off that much. It was just a slight bend in that post, but I wanted to use them old, I don't know if that's hickory or what, but that's heavy boards, has the corner post. All right, I'll nail this thing together. They're nailed on there. Now my center post, of course I'm gonna cut the tops off in boards. My center post, I found the middle, 35 inches, it's 70 inches wide. I found the middle, marked all the way down. Then I found the middle of the post, 1.75, marked that. And what I've done is I've lined, here's my mark here. I've lined my marks up, see that? Line my marks up, and now I'm going to shoot that middle post. So anyway, we're going to see how level it is. That board's a little crooked. Let's flip. That board was a slight bit crooked. So we flip it a little bit. And what I'll do is I'll pull it up just a tad. Make sure I'm still flush around here. I wasn't. I'll pull it up just a tad to compensate for it. Coming along quite smoothly. Now we're going to need a level again. This board's not straight. Hooking that board. You know what? There's a piece of bottom piece of this board missing. That's why you need to use a level. Isn't that something? So I'll put one nail in, and then I'll raise this other end to compensate. All right, now we'll put the level on. Like I said, when you're using reclaimed lumber, you're going to have to use the level, and you're going to have to adjust accordingly, because there is no way. You know what? It's not just reclaimed lumber. I've went to Lowe's and Home Depot and a local lumber mill, and you can't get 10 straight boards. Well, I'm sure you can somewhere. Sure you can someplace. But when you're building stuff, you have to compensate for. That's got a 3 on it. This was a board left over from building a sheep barn. So I'll sand it off, but I'll put it at the back for now. So little Miss Muffet don't go, "What's with the 3? What's with the 3? Anyway, when I was a talent scout in Nashville, Don Reed, the guy I worked for, Affinity Music, he sent me out to see this group, this guy and this lady. So I went out and looked at them. They sang really well. Saw them in a club, and I gave them a card and told them to come to Nashville and let Don to see them and so forth and so on. But when they got to Nashville, the guy was, I guess, 5'9", maybe 5'9 and a half, and the girl was about 5'11". Well, I get there and they get out of the vehicle, and the little guy's wearing a big hat and the girl's wearing a small hat to compensate. To compensate for their height. I mean, they were dead on with the girl wearing a short hat, black hat, and the guy wearing a tall one of those that the Hoss used on Bonanza. You know, those tall rounded top hats. So we get in the studio, and the engineer's there, Don Reed's there, and I'm there. And they in there, they got their headphones on, and we have the mics off. And Don looks over to me, and he goes, "So what's with the hats?" Anyway, little Miss Muffet has me tell that story all the time. We always talk about Don Reed. I guess he's about 65 now. We always talk about Don Reed saying, "So what's with the hats?" That's funny shit. You had to be there. She had a short, one of those old short women, black women hats, you know, with the real short top. And he had that real tall. That board is totally off. See that? I should have not told my story. See, that board's totally off. It's off about a hair. I'm gonna have to fix it. We're gonna have to pull it out. I can't have it off. It's too off for me. It's too off for me. Let me pull it out and reshoot it. Can't believe I didn't. I was only gonna put one in the end and compensate for it. And if I didn't shoot all three of them, I just pull it right off. Watch it split. Would put three of them in it, wouldn't I? Luckily, it's not the pressure treated board. Boy, that's what happens when you use 3.5-inch nails. She's coming. She's coming. Shouldn't have been telling my story. Shouldn't have been telling my story. There's no way I'm finishing this before dark. I get the hammer. No way I'm finishing her before dark. Make sure she don't split. Did cut the video, but what's the point? Gotta see how you fix messed ups, don't you? Nail guns. You love them, and then you hate them. You love them, then you hate them. I don't know why that board's so off. We're going to take the nails out, and we'll shoot her again. We'll try her again, and hopefully I won't tell no stories and forget what I was doing. Remember, I'm compensating for the bend in this. Compensating for the bend in this, and I'm compensating for the bend in the boards. So, and that was the whole idea of the story, was about compensation. The lady compensating for being taller than the man. It was hilarious. All right, back to where we were at. And I sat there and said it was off a little bit. Daggone, if I didn't shoot her anyway. Now we're going to have to... We're going to have to flip it around. It's going to have that six sticking out because she's a little off. She's a lot off, actually. Well, that evened it up a little bit. Look at that. That's pretty good. We're going to lift her just a tad. Crapola. Where did that go? Did it fall out on its own? Yes, it did. Something's run over with the tractor. Where did it go? Oh, crap. Alright. She shouldn't look too bad now. Remember, we gotta cut off the top. There's the sides of her. We gotta go ahead and do the other side. And then tomorrow I'll bring my chainsaw down from the shop and we'll whack off the tops of those. That one board is a little crooked on there, and that post is a little bent. This is a good post here. I wasn't gonna waste another one. It's a compost bin. It doesn't need to be absolutely perfect. It's a compost bin. All right. Get my board I was leaning on. I wish I knew where those nails fell. How could I not see them? Find them with the tractor tire, you watch. It's always two or three stuck in the thing. Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot this. And then we'll put the bottom front board on. And the only thing I gotta do is I'm gonna put welded wire in the middle and a welded wire thing that's gonna slip down to keep the animals out. You'll see it's welded wire panels. They're a little bit bigger. It's getting ready to rain on me again. A little bit bigger than the fence. Let me take this camera over here. It's starting to sprinkle again. Can't get anything done. The 2x6s. But I think I might run something different. Let's see what a 2x8 looks like. Let's see what a 2x8 will look like. Two by eight. I think I want a 2x12 there. I think I want to put a 2x12 there. It is. I got the bottom board on. I got to trim just a little bit. When I trim with the chainsaw, I'll trim that board. Got the center. Got the center board in. Now, there's going to be some slats for the welded wire to go in front, and there's going to be welded wire across the middle too. So, you know, this thing can be moved with the skid loader and the forks. It's not attached to the ground. So, but she's a bear. I tell you, you can't even lift her. You cannot even lift. It won't even budge. So anyway, we'll show you the rest of it tomorrow and see how it does. 6 a.m. Oh, I don't know if this camera's getting it, but look at the morning fog. Well, there's some of the compost bin. I gotta finish it today. I'll work on it later, but it's coming along really nice. It's looking pretty good, actually. I got my wire down here that I'm gonna make. I'm gonna put some wire between here, like that. It's gonna go in between. And I'm going to make some pieces to slide down in there as well. Main and sealant in one, 6-year protection. It's tinted green. And you can see it will get a little lighter once it soaks in. But as you can see, it's doing a real good job. So we're going to finish this up. We should have it done here in the next hour. And I'll show you what it looks like. Nicely. Now I also I just took the paintbrush and just dabbed over that wire a little bit. This is olive. This color is olive, and it's latex olive that they mix in with the stain. So it will coat wire just fine as well. So I coated that, it blends in nicely. I'm gonna do the front panels as well. I stained those metal pieces, those screens, wire, welded wire. It's all stained up, ready to go. Well, that's how I made a compost bin. Hopefully it helps you out, gives you some idea. It's gonna get enough air. It's gonna keep the animals out. I think it looks pretty decent. It'll fade a little bit. That's that Olympic stain and sealer. It's the Olympic Maxim stain and sealant. Stain and sealant in one, 6-year protection. Neutral base, tinted olive. And it will tone down. It'll get, I did the signs. I don't know if you've seen the turkey barn signs. And there's one hanging there for the sheep barn. And I did one at the road. They tone down quite a bit. It gets a lot lighter. So when you first do it, it's a little Miss Muffet's going to move the cows into this field, the sheep into the front. And then we're going to put the cows over in the summer field over there. It will tone down quite a bit, and you can also spray paint these welded wire too if you want to use that, and spray paint it yellow if you like, red, but you can spray paint it olive or black or whatever you want. But that sealant has that latex stain in it. And it'll coat this welded wire fine. Eventually it'll wear off, but for now, the thing of it is it is going to take us a year, if not longer, to fill this thing up. And then it's got to be turned and set, so it's going to be 2 years, probably year and a half before we get to use any soil out of it. So I'm mainly going to put kitchen scraps and garden scraps in it, food scraps and things like that. So we'll see. The sheep think they're going to get a treat. So we'll see how it turns out. I'll keep you posted on the compost when we have some. We have 8 huge 6-ton compost bins at the litter shed that we use for the farm compost. That's something totally different, and that's what I used in the bottom of that garden box. So we have huge compost bins, but this is going to be more for kitchen scraps and garden scraps. So there should be. I'll get this video all put together, show you how to build a compost bin if you like my design. There's quite a few different ways to do it. Some Buccaneer Plus. It's a weed killer, and we use it around the turkey barns. I mixed up some, and I'm gonna take and lay some fabric down underneath the compost bin, and I'm gonna put a layer of dirt on it, and then that way it gets it fills in the gaps on the bottom. But it also keeps all the weeds from growing, except for what's in this dirt. So, anyway, that's what I'm going to do to the bottom for the compost bin. Leveled all this out. I still have to rake it with the rake. But I cleaned up all these rocks. I leveled, put the layer in the bottom of the compost bin, and then leveled this out. And I don't know if I'm gonna plant grass this year or continue. We'll go see whether or not we're gonna lay any more rock. But I'll rake it, get the rocks out, and we'll see what it looks like when it's done.
I'm going to build those other boxes, though. I think I'm going to continue the deck. I think I'm going to... I got plenty of boards. So I think I'm just going to make a deck this direction, which will go into the fire pit. I'm not sure whether I'm going to do gravel, stone, deck, pavers. Not really sure yet, so we'll see. At least it's cleaned up for now.